So in terms of that general...
So who made no decisions then?
Well, for me, very simply, in terms of the task, I think Gabriella, I mean, she's sitting here now, obviously quite quiet, to be fair, but Gabriella, for me, is, in our team, from a contribution point of view, it's lacking.
I started to wonder whether, you know, he's a kind of an honourable fellow in the sense of the way he tries to deflect the responsibility away from himself. But Jenna just got the tone completely and utterly wrong. You didn't realise that this was a high-quality product and you should not have been making a humorous video in the beginning. Jenna, I'm sending you home. You're fired.
Thank you, Lord Sugar.
And just as I was about to also let Stephen go, he kind of leapt across the table.
All I can say to you, if I was project manager again, I would definitely deliver another victory. And most importantly, I would definitely deliver another victory.
You've thrown the gauntlet down. You are the project manager next, and I expect you to win.
The next morning, an early start.
I'm so positive today. I'm so motivated. I can't wait to get out. I really can't.
It was Stephen's last chance.
I was on the edge of a cliff, 1 foot over the edge, pulled back in, so I'm going to give 110%.
The task, find and negotiate cut-price offers for a Daily Deals website.
It's very simple, this task, actually. It's about negotiation and persuasion, fundamentally.
We're going to win this. It's 100%. Just how much we're going to win it by is all I'm thinking about.
Ricky had a rough start.
So you wouldn't be able to do any discount whatsoever?
No, I wouldn't even give you 10%.
OK, just wanted to clarify that crystal clear.
The product we use is a power whitening system.
While Stephen went for a multi-deal strategy.
So you've got your deluxe option with the home care kit, then we could perhaps have a deal for the without the home care kit, so you've got two options there. Is that something that sounds quite good for you?
So, yeah, absolutely.
Well, it's not a bad idea on the face of it. One particular company might have offered three or four different packages. Not a bad idea at all. What the bad idea was that the stuff that they found, all been done, all been seen.
Oh, Jesus, that's horrible. That feels...
It's tickly.
Oh, my God.
Gabrielle really pushed for the fish pedicure.
That is very popular, I know, at the moment.
But the CEO of the website was really clear that they only want luxury experiences.
Thank you very much, Ben.
It didn't surprise me one moment that the website turned around and said, no, thanks, we've seen all that before. Stephen and Gabrielle, they went off the rails.
Oh, I'm feeling a bit of pressure, I've got to be honest with you. I'm feeling a bit of pressure here. Lord.
In the boardroom, a crushing defeat.
The winning team came in with £14,000 worth of business compared to Stephen's £7,000. So it wasn't just a little loss, it was a big, big loss. The dentist and the fish thing. Did you not understand the need for something special on this website?
In all seriousness, I've never been to a fish spa in my life.
Again, under pressure, Stephen tried to shift the blame.
Gabrielle very much gave the advice that would be a good seller.
He was so indecisive. One minute we're doing this, one minute we're doing that, chopping and changing.
Focus on yourself. I think you've performed to your capability. Just focus on yourself, please,
for a moment. Can you let me finish, please?
Yeah, of course, but speak about you.
Yes, can you let me finish?
Please stop being so condescending. Let us speak.
In every task, I do try and adapt myself to the person I'm dealing with.
Yeah, OK. Gabrielle's a very bubbly person. I just get the feeling that she had hit the wall in the process, as far as I was concerned. Gabrielle, as nice a person as you are, it is with regret that you are fired.
And I'd like to thank you very much for the opportunity and well done, boys. And thank you very much.
For a moment, Stephen looked safe.
You asked me for the chance to be the project manager. I gave you the chance. You told me you were going to win. You didn't win. You lost. You're also fired.
That left five to fight for a place in the final.
This was the penultimate task, and so this was a bit of a sink or swim situation. The pressure was on, and they had to get it right. Your task is to create an affordable luxury product range. Adam, you're going to be project manager of Phoenix.
Fantastic.
Okay.
Thank you.
Good luck. Off you go.
Thank you. Good task, exciting, a lot to it. Name, identity, logo, packaging. Any ideas?
I have a lot of admiration for Adam in the way that he's grown throughout the course of the process. So I put him in charge because he's a good salesman, but was he an all-round good business manager?
I want to go down the road, I think, of chocolates, white chocolates, with a nice fold-up box with a ribbon on.
Sold on selling sweets, Jade headed up production.
This is like heaven. I always wanted to have a sweet shop. I think every little girl who's slightly podgy did. Mmm.
And Adam brainstormed brand names.
Obviously, chocolate, so Chocolike. Yeah, quite clever. Chocolocal. Lovely chocolate, Choc Stop.
I think what's important for us to remember is that we are creating a luxury brand. Things I've written down, Co-Co-Co, Co-Co-Cho, Cho-Cho-Cho.
Sounds like a train.
It is a bit like a train, but it's like a chocolate train. At the moment, what
you
kind of...
You could call it chocolate bar, as in chocolate bar and chocolate bar, do you know what I mean? The bar, the fact that we could have a counter in the style of maybe a bar. You could personalise the chocolate, again, like a bar. You can order it at the bar, chocolate bar.
Next job for the two boys, a chance to get a taste of their chosen market.
That's beautiful.
What kind of chocolates do you do? What flavours have you combined?
OK, we do a ginger, a lavender, a mint.
Adam and Nick had a wonderful opportunity to meet a businessman who's created a fantastic bespoke shop to help them put together their business model. What have they spent their time doing here? Tasting chocolate.
Called Sweet Thing, their shop was a hit.
Welcome to Sweet Thing, giving you a full chocolate flavour. Hopefully the most chocolatey kind of chocolates you've ever tried.
When I first saw their shop, I thought to myself, "Whoa, wow, this looks interesting. Colourful, lots of products. Superficially, it looked quite good."
But on the business front, it was a bit suck it and see.
What have you decided on your recommended retail price?
£2.99, it's tripling your money. What do you think, Nick?
£4.99.
Would you pay £4.99 for them, yeah?
You know, maybe you're right, maybe £2.99 is nearer.
So what is the pricing strategy as it stands now? That is selling for, at the moment, you're thinking £2.99 or £4.99?
Exactly.
On the other team...
It's going to be too fruity for a masculine product.
A men's grooming range from Ricky and Tom.
So you've got the shaving cream, the after balm and the moisturiser at the end.
Just to let you know, we do have a grooming experience for you this afternoon if you'd like to try it. And it'll be me who'll be giving you the refreshing experience as well, so you're in safe hands. And relax. I'm really glad you popped along.
Now, these two fellows, Ricky and Tom, were quite dapper chaps, and I get the feeling they were quite into it themselves.
Is that too hard or is that nice and soft?
No, that's fine.
After 2 days perfecting brands, teams had to present them to retail experts.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen.
And to Lord Sugar.
Modern Gentleman is a concept which is going to target traditional grooming visions and values and bring that to the modern man.
Ricky and Tom really had thought up their plan.
The UK's market is 862 million right now and growing.
So it actually worked, it actually had legs.
What we'd like to do is take this outside of the UK, and starting within Europe gives us the advantage because the export links are extremely good. Please feel free to ask any questions.
Next to face the experts, Adam.
Morning, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for giving us the time to introduce our brand, Sweet Thing.
Regretfully, Adam didn't put up a very good pitch.
What we've tried to achieve is affordable luxury. Ideal for Christmas, birthdays, Easter, and Valentine's Day, which we think will be our busy periods. Our target market, hopefully, will appeal to absolutely everyone, whether that's coming back from the office or just for a girly night in, or whatever you fancy, to be honest.
When you looked into his eyes, you saw a man who, I think, himself realised that he'd kind of reached the end of a great journey. Adam, I've got to tell you that you have impressed me in the manner in which you have thrown yourself into everything headfirst. However, there are other areas I have to consider. The shrewdness, the awareness, the getting the plot, and that's maybe where you're a little bit lacking. He himself might have realised in the end that it was time for him to go. I think all in all, on this very, very difficult decision I've got to make, I'm going to have to say that, Adam, you're fired.
Thank you, Lord Sugar.
I wish you all the best for the future, Adam, and I hope you do well.
Thank you very much.
And keep in touch.
If you ever need a salesman, you know where I am.
OK.
Thanks very much. Well done, yeah. Well done, mate.
Right, I'm down to my final four now. I've seen these people throughout the past 11 weeks, and they've all got different qualities. Ricky is a great salesperson, a great presenter. Tom, smart, seems to have ideas. He's shown some great work in the past, another good contender. Nick, a technical man, big on the web. He deployed his expertise throughout the course of the process. And then there's Jade. She can sell, she's creative, very quick, very fast thinking. So I got four very, very good candidates to go forward to the final, where I will be delving much deeper into their business plan ideas and to see which of the four is going to be my business partner. Today is all about convincing me on your business ideas.
I've been looking forward to this encounter.
You don't own that website.
You've blown it in 6 months.
It's like being in a war zone.
It's the opportunity of a lifetime.
You're going to be my business partner.
The Apprentice Final, Sunday at 8:30 on BBC One.